Hello, Jerome.
Yeah, hello. Thank you very much for the introduction. So I share my screen.
Managing Director for CF Turbo. So thanks, we can see your screen, Jerome.
Okay, that's fine. So then, welcome again, everybody, to my presentation. So CF Turbo is quite a new product in the QFinSoft product portfolio, and therefore I would like to start with a company introduction first and then give you an overview about the software CF Turbo in general. And in the last part, I would like to show you some possible workflows with ANSYS simulation products as a state-of-the-art option of turbo machinery design currently. Okay, some facts to the company itself. CF Turbo was established in 2008 and the headquarter is in Germany. And for 4 years now, we have another office in the US in New York City. So our main business is the turbo machinery design software CF Turbo, which we are developing and selling worldwide and organizing training and all these stuff. So in addition, we provide consulting services in the field of turbo machinery, so mainly focused on, of course, design, but also on flow and strength simulations and also optimization, of course. So that means this third field of activity here, the workflow development, is quite important for a lot of our customers, that we create automated workflows in different simulation systems available on the market, including design exploration, design of experiments, optimization, and all these modern approaches. Yeah, beside our two offices, we have distributors around the world on the main markets. And yeah, recently among our distributors, there are three ANSYS channel partners, and QFinSoft is one of these ANSYS channel partners. Yeah, if you are looking on the industries we are addressing, there are a lot of different fields related to turbo machinery applications, and you see some examples here. Our current customers coming from both sides, from the large corporations, multinational corporations, and also from medium-sized and small businesses. And the users itself can be from beginners up to experts. So we try to make the software as intuitive and user-friendly as possible, that everybody could use the software without experienced knowledge in turbo machinery design. Okay, this is an overview about some of our most important customers. Of course, they are mainly located in the areas of North America, Central Europe, and Eastern Asia. But hopefully it will develop also in the African area in the next years. Okay, now some words to the software CF Turbo itself. It's a conceptual design system for turbo machinery components. So we are supporting the most important component types, impellers, stators, and volutes. And this is addressing the four most important machine types in turbo machinery. These are pumps, fans, compressors, and turbines. And for the impeller shapes, we are supporting both types, the centrifugal and mixed flow type, and also the axial type. So that means we are covering the whole range of turbo machinery and also some special impeller types that we will see later. Okay, all of these components have several detailed design steps. And this is an example only here for the impeller mainline design step. So that means we have normally on the top left a design window where we can make modifications in the geometry, and then we have a lot of informational diagrams here on the right side, which could be customized by the user to check velocity distributions, area, angle distributions, and all this stuff. So CF Turbo not only supports single stage designs, but also multi-stage designs. And this is an example of a three-stage bowl diffuser pump, including the, or not only the main flow path design here, but also the solid design on hub and shroud side, and also the so-called secondary flow path connecting impeller outlet and impeller inlet. So that means the geometry models could be quite complex, and that ends up in such complex 3D models, which has to be handled then in the simulation systems. So if you are looking on the product workflow of a typical turbo machine, then CF Turbo is located normally at the beginning of this process. So afterwards, there are two options. We could use the modern approach of simulation workflows, or alternatively, of course, you could use interfaces of CF Turbo to CAD systems and use rapid prototyping methods and experiments to get the results of your design. Of course, normally based on the simulation or measurement results, you have to step back to the design system and run iterative loops to find the optimum solution. And this optimization could be interactive or manually based on the experience of the user. Or of course, you could use optimization software like ANSYS Design Explorer or OptiSlang. And we will see some examples later in this presentation. From the design methodology that we are using in CF Turbo, we are starting with the design point, which should be the best efficiency point. That means we have to put in these few numbers, which are listed here. That's the volume or the mass flow rate, a head or total pressure difference as the energy transmission of the machine, the rotational speed, some fluid properties, and some inlet boundary conditions has to be defined. And what we are doing in CF Turbo, we are using all the fundamental equations like the well-known Euler equation of turbo machinery and all the conservation equations, relations in velocity triangles, slip models, and all these stuff. And in addition, CF Turbo uses a lot of empirical correlations and functions, which are public available in books and papers, but can also be customized by the user if he has special experience or special knowledge to their special product. They could put in these correlations into the software to customize it. So at the end, the result of CF Turbo is a 3D CAD model, which is completely parametric. It could be a solid model of the fluid domain and the solid domain. So that means this can be handled in flow simulation or in FEA simulation systems. And of course, CF Turbo is ready to run in batch mode so that it could be easily integrated into design exploration optimization workflows. Here are some examples of geometries that can be designed with CF Turbo. So it starts with simple 2D geometries, 2D blades for centrifugal pumps, for instance. Or here's an example of a more mixed flow type and stator blades here on the backside of the impeller, and ends up with high specific speed pumps or fans with axial impellers. So then we have a lot of specialized impeller types like inducers here, for instance, for pumps to improve the suction capability, or squirrel cage blowers, which are typically used for air conditioning systems, for instance, or an automotive cooling fan here on the bottom right side as an example. Yeah, we are supporting, of course, splitter blades for compressor design as an example, and yeah, the actual turbine stuff for impeller blades and stator blades. So now some words to the coupling to the ANSYS products. Yeah, CF Turbo, this is most important, is integrated into the ANSYS workbench. That means you can simply create such a subsystem for CF Turbo and connect it to other tools which are available in the ANSYS workbench. So if you start CF Turbo from the ANSYS workbench, you have an ANSYS workbench button here in CF Turbo available. And clicking on that button, you have all the parameters available which define the complete geometry of such a machine. And you can select all the parameters which should be available in the workbench for other products. And furthermore, you could define so-called export actions, so you can connect single components of your design to ANSYS products. Currently, we are supporting ANSYS TurboGrid for meshing vane geometries and ANSYS BaseClaim for all the other types of casings, for instance, which is then connected with ANSYS meshing. Okay, this is a workflow, how it typically looks like. So CF Turbo is connected to ANSYS meshing using the BaseClaim interface and the TurboGrid. And important to know is that all the parameters that you have selected in CF Turbo are available in the parameter set and can be connected to other systems. So, and this is an example of using the ANSYS Design Explorer in these workflows for a design of experiments. So that means the parameter set is connected to this Design Explorer subsystem. And this is an example of a quite very easy or the most simple design of experiments. We are using a single parameter only, and this is the wrap angle of an impeller blade in this example. So that's quite simple for illustration only. You can define lower and upper bounds. And of course, in the CFX system that we are using for the on the solver side, we have to define some result parameters like the total pressure difference and the efficiency in this example. So, and after running the DOE, we have these simple correlations on the screen quite easily. In this example, it's the efficiency of the machine depending on the on our parameter, that's the wrap angle. Okay, and of course you can start the next step then. You can connect the design of experiments with a optimization in the Design Explorer. And this normally starts with selecting the parameters in CF Turbo, which then are available in the workbench. In this example, we have five parameters of the impeller available in the workbench and three parameters of the volute. Then, of course, you have to select your objectives, which normally is the stage efficiency, but can also be the suction capability of a pump or something other, or a minimum design space requirement or something like that. And you can define constraints. In this example, we have defined one constraint that the pressure difference or pressure ratio of the stage should be around 3. So, and after running the optimization, you get your best design candidates, and then you can select the preferred one. And in CF Turbo, it's quite easy to compare different designs. And in this example, our initial design in green color is compared with the optimized design, and you can easily locate the differences that are driven by the optimization process. Okay, furthermore, you get a lot of more information about the optimization run. For instance, this history chart, in this example, it's for the impeller diameter D2, how the optimizer is finding the perfect solution for this parameter. And of course, you can create these well-known response surface charts for dependency of the parameters. In this example, the impeller efficiency is displayed depending on the blade angle beta B2 and the blade wrap angle phi to create some knowledge about the dependency of the parameters. So an alternative option for optimization is ANSYS OptiSlang. So we have a long time cooperation also with ANSYS OptiSlang, which are located in Germany. That means CFTurbo is an integral part of OptiSlang. There's a native CFTurbo interface available in OptiSlang, and you can easily create workflows in OptiSlang like that, connecting CFTurbo with TurboGrid here in this example, some Python scripting to prepare the solver run, and then CFX is used here as a solver in this example, but it could be ANSYS Fluent or ANSYS Mechanical or any other solver system available inside ANSYS. So as an alternative, of course, OptiSlang could be used also inside the ANSYS workbench. This is an example of such a workflow. So typical connecting CFTurbo with meshing and the solver system and the parameter set, which comes from CFTurbo and from the solver side, could be connected to OptiSlang subsystems, like in this example for these bowl diffuser pump here. And at the end, you get these very nice OptiSlang pictures after running the optimization, illustrating the correlation between different geometry parameters and the target values, or the sensitivity of most important geometry parameters. That's quite interesting to know. And of course, these parallel coordinate plot to illustrate the influence of design parameters on the objectives like efficiency. Okay, that's it as a short overview about CFTurbo. And I think during this conference, you will get some more information in some other sessions about CFTurbo and specific applications of the software. Okay, thank you very much for your attention. And yeah, I'm ready to answer your questions.
Thanks a lot, Jero. That was very, very informative. And as you said, there is actually a presentation from Stellenbosch University where they have used CFTurbo. So if anybody is interested in getting more in-depth presentation on it. So thanks a lot.